In this video, I'm going to discuss about our basic need as a need for time structure. So this is again a continuation with our series, most interesting series on transaction analysis. So the last video was on strokes. So people who missed it, please do catch up with the last video because it's like in continuation with that. So I've given the link in the description, so please do watch it. So here we're going to see, as a human being, how are we going to structure our time? And you'll be surprised to know that, do we indulge in these kind of things just to kill our time or, you know, give some structure to our lives? So Eric Byrne has talked about 6 ways we human beings structure our time. So he also said like these 6 things, 6 ways of time structuring also will give us more strokes, and the intensity of the strokes and the frequency will differ depending on how we are choosing to spend your time. And the way we are trying to spend our time is again an imprint of how you as a child was trying to spend your time, and based on your childhood, not like spending your time as a child, but based on your parental injections and your life positions, whatever you learn from the childhood, we are going to spend our time accordingly. Because for people who have this fear of rejection and who feel like indulging in human interactions is going to be more risky for me, or people might reject me or might neglect me, so these people stay away from it, you know. So they don't want to get strokes also, because they are like highly at risk. What if this person is not going to recognize me? So they're better to withdraw from people and the interactions. So this is the first type how people generally choose to spend their time. So just relate to what I'm saying, and you can just make a pie chart saying which is the type of time structuring activities you choose as a person and how you can restructure your time chart for a more fruitful human interactions and for a more effective life, as well as for our healthy psychological well-being also. So this time structuring types also will tell us whether we are going to, you know, become psychologically unhealthy or we are going to be more psychologically healthy. As I explain about these types, you will get a more better clarity. So the first concept, which I already mentioned, is like withdrawal. So human beings generally also choose to withdraw as a part of their life structure, you know, as a time structure. So first thing, when you have a day, like, you know, day starts from the morning and then you're given like some 24 hours a day. So how am I going to structure the day? Some people prefer to spend their time all alone, like they withdraw from people, even though they're going to be with group of people, as after all, we're all social animals. So when you got to interact with another person, even then they choose to psychologically withdraw from you. And they don't want that kind of strokes from another person also, because of the fear again. So you need to understand clearly, it's not that they don't want strokes, but they're afraid to receive it because of the risk of human interactions and because of the rejection path. So what they do is they get absorbed in their own fantasy. They can even create their own fantasy wherein they can stroke themselves also. But it's okay for us to spend some time to introspect or, you know, to have our own me time. That is all fine. But if you're going to spend most of the time in this withdrawal phase, it's not very healthy. Psychologically, it's not healthy. It's a point of concern. So just ask yourself, how much time do you actually want to spend in withdrawal? So we'll go to the next type of time structuring, that is rituals. So what I mean by rituals is like what we learned as an adopted child. Like, you know, saying hi, how are you doing, I think the day is good for you. All these are like formal transactions with which we involve ourselves when we meet people at work or at school or at college, wherever we see. So this is more of like a formal way of structuring time. So we use our usual words like this. It's like a more formal, I would say. So like hi, how are you, and all this stuff. So this is called like rituals. So here, the risk of the strokes and risk of the getting more close to people is quite less only. So people do involve in rituals without any problems. So this is fine. So and then we go to the next third type of category of time structuring, that is past time. So we can even call it as past time, where two people or a group of people come together and discuss about their past times, you know. They talk about whatever. Maybe if two women get together, they can talk about things, stuffs. And when two males, they can talk about motors or whatever topic they would like to. Or a lot of group of old people come and meet in the park, they can talk about the health. So these are all like past times. So talking about the health, talking about makeup, and talking about various topics. Here it is not like very structured, or it's not like more goal oriented. They're not going to involve in action, but they're just going to talk. So this is like a time where we spend more of, you know, we are like the time wasters, I could say, but we can still involve in this kind of pastime, but make sure that your past tense is not going to take the most important part in your pie chart. So by this also we try to receive strokes. And one important thing, you may question me like, why do we even engage in this kind of time structuring and different types of time structuring? It's again a way or a trick to receive strokes. So when we talk to people and when we have this kind of transaction, we do receive strokes. So it can be positive or negative even in past tense. So people with similar kind of interests get together and they have more complementary transactions. So it's not quite risky even here. One more thing is about the types of structuring is activity, where like group of people come together and they perform an activity. It can be like work or it's like playing football, where it is more goal oriented, more action oriented. At the end of it, what you receive, it can be a positive stroke if you win, if you get a good performance, or a negative stroke if you don't. Next type, we talk about games. This is the most important and most surprising component of people's interactions, called games. But about games, I think I need to put a separate video on this, because this is very interesting and this is having a lot of unconscious relevance, and where the games people play, a lot of books are available on this particular concept on games and transaction analysis. So I think that I should do more justice to this part. So I'll explain more detail in a separate video on games. So but here, let's say like how people spend time is by games, wherein they exchange the transactions to get some payoffs. Okay, so payoffs in the sense like at the end of the games, they just exchange a lot of strokes. It can be more negative strokes and they end up feeling negative. And that's why again they play the game. So this will continue, and this is like highly unconscious and subconscious. When I talk about games in other video, you'll understand more better, and you will be exactly getting into the patterns of games you play based on your life scripts. So this is also one way. Most of the times people enter into these games just to pass their times. So this is the games part. So the next most important part is intimacy. This is very positive. All the human being, the basic need is to get intimate, get more intimate in their transactions. But here again, this is a high risk is there, because the fear of rejection is a lot of, lot in human beings. So they don't prefer to get into this intimacy where they spend more time. But this is very healthy. But people do fear this. So that is why they don't want to get into this intimacy where they spend time talking about, mostly the natural child we mean play. And there will be a lot of complementary transaction where the transactions will be like more explicit. And it's like, they can talk about how they really feel. It's more genuine. It's more uncensored. So people talk about their real feelings, real emotions, and there is no ulterior transactions here. So in the first video, I've talked about the types of transaction and all. Here, the types of transaction is completely complementary, and people talk from their child, another person from the nurturing parent, or a child to child. It's natural and it's very good and positive. People do get a lot of strokes during this intimacy, how they prefer to spend or structure their time. But unfortunately, most of the times people don't spend their time in this realm. So this has got a lot of significance in marital life as well. So I'll just give you an interesting example to relate with all this kind of time structuring. Let's say there is a newly married couple, and let's say they're craving for strokes. As I already told, every human being would like to get some strokes. But what they do is like during the night, as the night approaches, they're just going to use their social media. They're going to be just occupied on their cell phones. And when the time for intimacy comes, or the time to sleep, or the time where they really have to talk about each other, this is where the fear comes. So what they do is they just end up playing games. So not games like computer games, this is a games in transaction analysis, which is definitely not healthy. So games give them a lot of strokes and they get the familiar feeling, and they end it up and they fight and then sleep. So because of the fear of intimacy, people do engage in games. Instead, what they could have done is they could have spent their time in a more structured way of, going for a walk or something in the evening, so that they could have got some strokes. Just because they were lacking strokes, they were ending up in fight. So that has given them some strokes, that is negative also. So finally they got that hunger for recognition that was satisfied, so then they went to sleep. So rather, if they could have chosen to go for a walk together in the evening, obviously they could have had a communication with each other, the channels would have got open, and they would have got strokes also. So by the time they come and the night is approaching, then that would have given them the platform to open up about themselves, open about the real feelings without the fear of rejection or whether what she would think of me or are they going to reject me. Without any fear, they could have gone to the intimacy area. So you should understand that this time structuring is very important, and many people are unaware about how they're actually killing their time. Just imagine for a minute, if you don't have anything to do, like you feel like going mad, I need to do something, I need to talk to someone. So why are we doing it? The basic need is to receive strokes. So when you know this actual secret behind why do we even want to connect to people and talk to them, and then you'll be able to constructively structure your time. So instead of getting into more games and withdrawal, which are not very effective way of structuring your time, you can look into more of intimacy areas, or we can look into more of pastime or rituals also. That is also not that bad. But then our human need is to get more intimacy. So we should not fear that. So we need to look how to structure most of the times to get strokes in a more positive way. And also see your pattern for the last 1 week, like what is the kind of time structuring you have done and which are the areas do you think you're spending. So ask yourself whether you're spending time mostly in withdrawal or in rituals or in pastime or in activity or in games or finally in intimacy. Obviously, as human beings, we will structure our time within all the six types of time structuring, but where you spend most of the time makes you psychologically healthy or not healthy. So just introspect yourself and put it in the comment box what is the preferred time structure for you, and give it a thought like where you really want to improve on your time structuring, as this is our basic need. So we'll continue discussing a lot of interesting concepts in transaction analysis in the forthcoming videos in a series on transaction analysis. So catch you again in the next video. Have a very nice day. Bye.